everyone, and welcome once again to Andy's Smart Life. So one of the biggest questions that I get asked, particularly since I did a video previously on a workaround to get RTE player working on the Fire TV stick, is how to get Virgin Media player working on the Fire TV sticks. Well, the good news is there has been a big update on this in the last couple of weeks, and Virgin Media have actually released a dedicated Android TV version of their player. Now, does this work on the Fire TV sticks? Well, yes and no. So the good news is that if you've updated your Fire TV stick recently, you should now be able to find the Virgin player in the store or through searching on the Fire TV stick, install it, log in, and it'll work natively. But if this doesn't work, there is a workaround using Apps to Fire, which is the same technique that I used to install the RTE player on the Fire TV stick. So very quickly in this video, I'm going to show you both methods. And if one doesn't work, if the native way doesn't work, then at least you have the kind of backup way. Unfortunately, as ever, the Fire TV sticks, the software versions seem to be inconsistent. The ones that you get in Ireland seem to be very inconsistent. So the first way will probably work for most people, but if it doesn't work, at least there's a backup to kind of use the mobile phone that you have to manually install the Virgin Player app. Folks, before we continue, I'd super appreciate it if you smash that old like button, turned it blue. Only takes 2 seconds, but really, really does help out the channel. Doesn't cost you anything, but make sure that it helps the YouTube algorithm so that more people see my videos. If you haven't already, go ahead and click subscribe. That's super appreciated. But other than that, let's get back to the video. One very quick and important thing to note before we continue though is that this only seems to work for the Virgin Media player in Ireland. And what I mean by that is the Virgin Media Ireland player. It doesn't seem to work for the UK variant of it just yet. So if you're watching in the UK, this doesn't seem to apply to you guys yet. The other thing to note is that from what I've heard, a couple of people have told me that they are Irish viewers, they've done this and they're in the UK, and it doesn't work either. So the app may well be geo-locked so that it'll only actually play either on a VPN that says you're in Ireland or when you're in Ireland. Haven't had a chance to fully test that out yet, but it does seem like it's only for Irish customers and it's only for in Ireland. So just a very important point to note before we go further. So the first thing to do is go into your Fire TV stick, go all the way to the end and into the settings and the about section of the device. So what you want to do is make sure first and foremost that the Fire TV stick or the Fire TV device that you're using is on the latest version. So it's updated to the most recent version that's available to you. Now, as I mentioned earlier, this is super inconsistent and there's no rhyme or reason as to why. The main thing I can think of is that Amazon has a tendency to release different versions in different years. So there are some of them that are a 2020 version or a 2021 version or a 2019 version of different devices. And although the hardware seems more or less the same, the software rollouts seem to be that little bit kind of jerky and a little bit inconsistent with who gets what and when. So just make sure that whatever your device is that you've checked that there's no available updates so that you're on the most recent one. The next thing, go back to the home screen and click search. So you want to go into the search and just look for Virgin Media. If you're in Ireland, you should now be able to find the Virgin Media player and install it. It's a bit fiddly, as you probably know, if you've ever installed one of these apps before, to try and sign in using your email and password. But once you get through that stage, you should be able to now browse and navigate the Virgin Media player with relative ease, and it should all work for you. It's a little bit slow and it's a little bit jerky at times and in places. And the reason for this, I think, is because they primarily aimed this at Android TV devices. So devices that are Android completely without the additional Amazon skin or the Amazon restrictions on it, and they just kind of worked backwards until they had a Fire TV version. Or maybe they just did one version and it just turned out that it worked on the Fire TVs as well. Who knows? All we know is that it does now work, all that, albeit that little bit jerky, and it's plagued with ads. You're gonna be watching so many ads every time you click into anything, but that's just par for the course, I think, using one of these player devices. So if this method doesn't work, the second option is to use Apps to Fire. So the way we do this is we actually install the Virgin Media player, the latest version, on our mobile phone, and we use Apps to Fire to send that version to the Fire TV stick itself. So first and foremost, you're going to need to make sure that your mobile phone is on the same wireless network as your Fire TV stick. You're going to need to make sure that the latest version of the Virgin Media player is installed, and you're going to need to make sure that you have this program called Apps apps to fire installed on your phone too. So the version that's currently updated is from about the beginning of April or the middle of April. It's version 5.0.15, so 5.0.15. You can check that in the Google Play Store, but it is the most up-to-date one as of recording this video. So install that from the Google Play Store onto your phone first and foremost. Next, you want to open up Apps to Fire, and if you're connected to your Wi-Fi network in Apps to Fire, you're going to want to look for your Fire TV stick. So make sure that you have the Fire TV stick switched on and that you have it on the ready screen, because the first time you connect using Apps to Fire, it's going to try and confirm that you want to connect. So what you're doing is you're searching for the Fire TV stick or Fire TV device. It should pop up with the IP address of your device. You click connect, and on the screen of your Fire TV stick, it's going to prompt you to say, do you want to have connections available? Little note, if you haven't done so already, you're going to need to turn on the developer options in your Fire TV stick. This allows you to install from unknown sources and add developer options and do things more customizable that you wouldn't normally do with the Fire TV stick. If you're stuck on any of these, please do check out the video I did about the RTE player, and that will guide you through the entire process. Okay, so now you've got developer options switched on, install from unknown sources switched on, you've connected Apps to Fire to your Fire TV device, and what you're going to do is you're going to scroll through the apps on your phone in Apps to Fire, select the Virgin Media Player and say install to the device or send it to the device. What's happening here is that your mobile phone is actually sending the application Virgin Media Player from your phone over your Wi-Fi to the Fire TV device and installing it for you. And it's installing that up-to-date version 5.0.15. So if all goes well, you will now see the Virgin Media Player icon on your home screen on the Fire TV device, albeit it's going to be a little bit squared out. It's going to have like a black surrounding on it, but this is fine. It doesn't matter about the icon. This should work just as well as the natively installed one. Again, you need to log in with your username and password. You don't need to do this beforehand on the phone because you're going to need to do it again on the Fire device anyway. Now, the thing is, neither of these options may work for you, and I'm going to be completely honest about that. And the reason, again, is because the Fire sticks are really inconsistent. And not only are they inconsistent with the hardware and the software updates, but also geo-tagging and geolocations and whatever else. I've come across people who've said that everything works fine for them. I've come across people who say nothing works for them. So there's no rhyme or reason that we have figured out just yet as to how this works. So with a bit of luck, option one works for you. If not, try option two. But if not, you may just have to wait until the next update or the next version of either the Fire Stick software or the Virgin Media Player. So folks, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, I would absolutely appreciate if you gave it an old like so more people can see it. I'd super appreciate if you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions on this or anything else that I've featured on the channel. As always, you can follow me on any of the social medias listed here, and do feel free to hit me up if you have any questions about this or anything else, or if you have any suggestions as to stuff that you might like to see featured on this channel in the future. Other than that, folks, thank you very much, and bye-bye for now.